Which is more random, a regular d20 or a 20-sided spin down? It's an argument as old as time or dice. In this video, we are going to test these dice. Those that don't make it will die. Make sure you like this video and share it with your friends. I'm sure they'll love to see it, the truth about dice. Logically, it shouldn't make any difference, though each have the same number of sides and the same shape. One is slightly smaller than the other. As long as there are no imperfections, any of the 20 sides have an equal chance to come up. And that's the problem. None of these dice are perfect. Here are how they can be imperfect. First, the material can be imperfect. There can be bubbles inside the dice. Some dice are made of multiple colors, and those could change the center of gravity. This can make the die off balance. Another obvious source of imperfection is the engraving. Each of the numbers removes a different amount of material. Casinos use six-sided dice with pips, so they can easily be balanced. Which side are you on? My hypothesis is the regular d20 will be more random, since the engraved numbers have both large and small numbers grouped together. The amount of material moved should be more balanced. A spin down has all the low numbers on one side and the high numbers on the other side. This should make a spin down roll high, since there would be more weight around the low numbers. So that's my prediction. Put your prediction in the comments below. Is a regular d20 or a spin down going to be more random? Or does it really even matter? Now let's test. But how? We did some research and watched some videos of others. One video used salt water to make the die more buoyant. He pushed on the die to see what numbers would come up, or if the die would spin. I don't know about you, but I don't roll my dice in salt water. Maybe we should. Another rolled each die 100 times and got the average. Their thought, getting closer to 10.5 would be more random. This sounds okay, but it doesn't seem like a good test. These dice have 20 sides, so if you roll 100 times, each side should only show up 5 times on average. That doesn't sound like a good sample. So we need to roll more times. Also, we should roll more dice. One die could be anomaly. And so we're gonna roll in 6 dice 1,000 times each. 3 spin downs and 3 regular d20s. And the ones that aren't random will be destroyed in a spectacular way. And one more thing. We have to make sure the rolls are fair. Casinos require the dice to hit a backboard, so we need to make sure the die will hit a wall, but it would be better if they hit more than one. 3 would be great. It's nearly impossible to hit 3 bumpers in a pool to make a clean shot. Well, I did say nearly. In our case, we built a test rig using Lego, our very own dice tower. This one is designed with a ramp on a hinge. There are 1x2s and 1x3s to create bounce points inside. And finally, we have the dice stopped by a wall. We don't want to be chasing dice and rolling off the table. If you would like better pictures of the tower we made, they're on youngmage.com. Just look for the post about this video. Let's get rolling. We'll calculate the average distribution. We really need to graph the distribution. So we have a Google Sheet to show us those results in real time. This was a lot of work and drove my mom crazy. Now here's the data. We have a link to this Google Sheet in the description below, and so you can see the data for yourself. And what are the conclusions? Well, our most random turned out to be a spindown. And the one that was most imperfect was a regular d20. That clear yellow d20 was also pretty close to the distribution average of 10.5. So I'm certain that's not a good way to judge the randomness of a 20-sided dice. The other four we tested seemed to follow that a spindown isn't as good as a regular d20. Well, sort of. Our data really shows that each die is different and rolls differently over the course of 1,000 rolls. Every regular d20 isn't more random than every spindown. If you want to be certain, you really need to roll a lot of times and see how it works. So maybe we need to roll a lot more dice. You can help. If you want to help out, copy our Google Sheet and perform your own experiment. Send us your data. And if we get enough responses, we may need to do a follow-up video. But I know you really only stuck around to see the dice destroyed. Remember, do not try this at home. That's why we're not at home. Thank you for watching. I have more videos coming out soon. So until then, Rhino out.